Hello everyone. Today I am been traveling about an hour south of Stockholm to Nyköping and the castle Nyköpings hus. So now we're gonna talk about the Nyköpings gästabud. Nyköpings gästabud. Gästabud is like a feast. And Nyköping is of course this town of Nyköping. So it's the feast of Nyköping. But this wasn't just another feast. This was the feast when the king had his both brothers killed. So in order to understand this drama, you have to know a little bit more about the different characters here. We had three brothers. Birger was the king of Sweden, and his younger brothers were Erik and Valdemar, and they were all grandsons to Birger Jarl, who was the most powerful man in the mid-1200s. But this all happened in 1317, and this fight had a little background to it, because Erik and Valdemar, they were really jealous at Birger, because Birger had gotten to be a king, and Valdemar and Erik, they were in control of different parts of Sweden, but they wanted more, they wanted real power, maybe to have their own countries. The fight between the brothers had been going on for years, but in 1317, Birger, the king of Sweden, he wanted to reconciliate with his brothers and become friends again. King Birger invited his brothers here to Nyköping and to the castle at Nyköping to have a big party. All of this was white, all of this was snow, it was probably cold, and the horses came here with the brothers Valdemar and Erik, and they met their brother King Birger, and then the drama started. So the brothers Valdemar and Erik, they said yes to attending the Christmas party which King Birger had invited them to. So they were riding with the horses with all their soldiers and men, close men, to this place here. And now the Christmas party started. So when the brothers came here on this direction and they went into here, up there, they had the big Christmas feast and they were really partying and a lot of drinking and a lot of eating, and you know, this was the king, he had a Christmas feast, so you can understand how big it was. And then the brothers were really drunk and tired, and they had an accommodation somewhere here. You can't really know exactly where, but somewhere in this castle, the brother would stay the night. So let's go into the courtyard here to see how it looks here. But Birger had told the brothers that their soldiers couldn't be here. There weren't room for the soldiers. The soldiers had to stay inside Nyköping somewhere. So then, at night, Birger arrested his brothers. Ah, look at this. This is where Erik and Valdemar were sitting. This is where they died. Look at this. I've never been here before. Wow. The tower was as high as the King's Tower and as powerful. And in the bottom, this was where Valdemar and Erik died. All of this started a civil war in Sweden. Erik was a real powerful man, he had a lot of friends and was strong militarily, and they attacked Nyköping. So when the friends, the troops of Valdemar and Erik were attacking Nyköping, King Birger decided he has to flee, but he didn't want to give away Valdemar Erik to his enemies. He took the key to the tower and stood up there and threw the key inside the river. Erik and Valdemar, they were trapped inside the tower, and eventually they starved to death. Since King Birger had fled down to Denmark, and Valdemar and Erik were killed here, the men around Erik and the widow of Erik took power, and in 1319 they made the three-year-old son of Erik king of Sweden. And his name was Magnus Eriksson, and he was one of the longest-serving kings of Sweden. Okay, everybody, Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, share it to your friends and watch the next video. I hope to be back maybe in a couple of days from another historical place of Sweden. Bye bye.